In this video, we are going to see about a beam, which is an example from the Ramamritam textbook. So we'll analyze this beam and we'll find out the maximum bending moments and we'll compare with the textbook values. Okay. So this is the beam I'm going to analyze here. So here the beam is of it is a continuous beam, and the supports are being hinge support. Okay. So here we are having 2 meter span, 6 meter span, 8 meter and 2 meter again. So total combined together we are having 6 plus 2, 8 and 16 plus 2, 18. So total total continuous beam length is 18 meters. So just coming back to StatPro, I am going to create that beam by using the run structure wizard. Just going for geometry menu and click on run structure wizard. And yeah, so just going for frame models and double click on the continuous beam. So just I'm going to take the total length as 18, and here number of base is 4, since the total continuous beam is divided into four spans. So since they are not equal, I have to divide this into the required span length. So first one is 2 and next one is 6, next one is 8 and another one is 2. So total, if you are adding up this one, you are going to get the 18 value here. So click on OK and apply. So you can directly transfer by closing the window, or you can click on this one. Okay. So just going for close, and it is asking, would you like to transfer or mesh this prototype into StatPro? Yes. And it will be placed in the window here, geometrical window. So it is asking to specify the location. Default it is located at 0,0, and so just click on OK. And yeah, we got this beam here. And just going for general tab. Just we need to assign the first properties. I'm going to assume the properties of 0.23 by 0.23 squared here. So for analysis, properties are not taken into the account. For design, we are going to consider these properties. Of course, these properties plays a role. Just click on add and close, assign to view and assign. So it is asking to proceed, yes. And next one is support conditions. So just I want to attach hinge support. So in previous video we have seen fixed support. I want to attach the pin support. So just click on pin and add, close. So supports, just I want to assign for 3 supports here, just keeping in front view. And you can highlight these 3 nodes here. Okay. And if you want to see the nodes, just use Shift K so that we can see the all the nodes. So I'm highlighting these all the 3 nodes, assigned to selected nodes, assign and yes. And the next step is we need to apply the loads and definition. If you observe, we have seen the UDL in the example, right? We are having 30 kilonewtons in first 2 spans and 45 kilonewtons in second 2 spans. So now we are going for load case details. So I am going to consider this as a normal loads. I don't want to define any loading type. In previous class we have seen dead and live. Right now I am going to keep it as none. Just I want to analysis for the given loads. So I am not assigning any loading type here. You can change the title case or let it be load case 1. And click on add and close. So load case 1 again, add. And the next one. So just go for member load, and here we are having uniform force. First one is minus 30, so minus 30, so add, and another one is minus 45. So we are indicating minus, since load is applying towards negative y direction, so we are applying minus 45 in gy direction. Gy is nothing but global y direction. Okay, so add and close. We have added 2 values here. So select 30 kilonewtons. 30 kilonewton per meter and assign to required beams here. So just I'm going to highlight these 2 beams. Assign to selected beams, assign, and yes. Similarly, just select this one and select these 2 beams again. So assign to selected beams, assign, and yes. Next step, just we can go for analysis print. We can print all. If you add up the loads, 30 into 8, I mean, like if you observe the loads here, we are getting 30 kilonewtons on total 8 meter span. I mean, like we are applying for 2 meters and 6 meters. So here 30 into 8, 240, and similarly 45 into This one is 8 plus 2, 10, 450. So we are going to get 240 plus 450, that is 690 kilonewtons total load. We'll see whether it is 690 or not in the analysis or in the output. Already I have added the analysis print command. So I'm just going for control F5, or we can click on analyze here. Just go for run analysis and save. Analysis will be running here. So we got the analysis report. Just I'm clicking on view output file and done. I want to check whether the total load is 690 or not. When we are going for the output file, we can check the loads here. So just going for results, and we can see total applied load is 690. Okay, 690 kilonewtons. And just I'm going to close this one. Just you can go for post processing and apply. Click on OK. Now I want, since here we are seeing the displacement figure here, I want to show you the maximum bending moments. So here this icon is for deflection. I'm just closing that one, and I'm going for MZ bending moment. So you can observe the bending moment diagrams here, and if you want to see the values for this one, just go for results menu, and here we can see the view value. Click on view value. So you can select the maximum option here and click on annotate. We'll be getting values on the screen near this bending moment graph. So I want you to check these values with the textbook values, textbook results. Okay. So here if you observe, at the first hinge we got 60, and here it is also 60. Okay. And similar way at this middle hinge it is 224.885. Here it has been round off to 225. And here it is 90 kilonewton meter, and here is also 90 kilonewton meter. Okay. So we can rely upon the stat pro to get the accurate results. Okay. So just I want to show the comparison between the manual results and the software results. Hope you understood this video and you like this content. If you like this content, please give a like for this video, share with your friends, and please do subscribe for my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.